On this episode, we talk about Louisiana, the chosen few MC, racial tensions high, 3%ers, 1%ers, where everybody stands, and we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Shout to the ghosts and the ghostettes. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost. I'm your host for the evening. And today we're going to talk about it. Louisiana, racial divide getting worse and worse all over the country. Statues being torn down. People are starting to take a stand, and we cannot let ourselves racially be divided. We're gonna get into the whole situation, what's going on in Louisiana with the chosen few MC. But the first thing I want you to do, like we always do on this channel, is to hit me with that pound ghosting, and that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on twos, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. Shout to all my new subscribers. Welcome to the row. Follow the Instagram at Demons Row, at Sos the Ghost _. We constantly posting different kind of content that's not on the channel right now, so check that out. Follow the Sos the Ghost page. I'm going to drop my first video on there next week. And also, big shout to everybody. I've been seeing the ghosting t-shirts everywhere. Big shout to everybody, the love and support you give. Amazing. This week's certified ghostette goes out to a very special lady, Muñeca, representing California. She has some dope music. She's very talented. The name of her group is Proland Music. Y'all go check out on Instagram, Moon_Yeka. Follow her. Muñeca, you are a certified ghostette. This week's certified ghost goes out to my mentor, my big brother, Doc, president of Thug Riders MC 1%. Him and my other big brother, Nick, who doesn't like to be on camera or doesn't like any of the light, they are the ones that mentor me and make me great and make me want to be the best at what I do. So much love to you, big brother. You are a certified ghost. Alright y'all, let's get into it. I've been getting a lot of heat. I don't know if y'all realize it, but I've been getting shadow banned. I got kicked off of Facebook. And my message, there must be some truth in my message. And my message is simple, is we can't be divided. And I don't understand why I'm being targeted. I think I kind of get it, but I'm just trying to investigate what the truth is. So I just talk from the heart and I tell you what I feel, and then you take it how you want to take it. Nobody says that, like, I know for a fact anybody's intentions. I can't tell you what a 3% is thinking, or I can't tell you what a 1%er on another coast is thinking. Everything that I say, I understand that my views are far reaching because the show is growing, which is a beautiful thing. But I always lay out both sides of it, and I don't stand on one thing. And also, I don't backpedal. If I say something, I stand by it. But if I'm wrong, I'll say I'm wrong. But what I see that's going on, and the reason why I'm starting to get blocked and shadow banned, if you seen my last video, they even were just trying to be protective, because the last video was about, I was talking about old ladies. And for like a day or two, they had me shadow banned, where if you type in Demons Row, you don't even see the new video I just did. I guess out of fear of what I've been talking about lately. So if I ever get banned, it is what it is. I have to stand for what I believe in, and I have to talk about what's going on. I have to do my part, because this is history. These are historic times, and you have to stand your ground. As a man, you have to, you know, you have to plant your flag in the ground. And right now, what's going on in Louisiana with the chosen few 1% clubs that have black members in it, mostly black 1% clubs or mixed clubs, like the chosen few is like my club. They're very diverse, and they're one of the first diverse. So big shout to them, big shout to Red Man. And you know, right now in Louisiana, there was a situation where now it's getting family involved, because you have family of protesters or good friends of protesters saying, when I go to a protest, there's racist groups that are targeting us. They're standing there fully armed, and 3%ers are with them. And it's like they're pretty much taking a stand that they're on this side of the track. Now, I know if you've seen my 3%er videos, I understand that the 3%ers are there to protect from rioting, from, you know, them just destroying, you know, history. And I know that, but then also my message to the 3%ers, if you're standing there trying to protect our country, you have to also understand that if a racist group is there with you and they're inciting people that would do that, then they're doing their part to not defend the country too, because they're inciting the riot. So it's not just the people who do the rioting, it has to be the people inciting the riot. So as a 3% nation, if you're trying to protect the country, you have to protect it from everybody, not just blacks, you know, not just BLM, whatever group it is. You have to protect from any enemy. And if you're inciting a riot, then you are an enemy also. And to the racist groups that are in these places, I understand people have a pride towards their own culture. Some people don't like another culture. But when it comes to defending this country, you need to put that to the side and let people know, listen, we're here not because we hate black people, because you do, and you've openly said it. But we're here to protect history. We're here to protect our country from being destroyed. Stop being controlled by the media or your daddy or your mommy who taught you not to like black people, to make it where we all get oppressed just because of your racist views. Because if this continues, there's armed people on both sides. They are going to bring the military in. And I'm gonna say it's on blue in the face, because a lot of people are not getting it, and there's no media talking about it, because all they do is promote the protests. And the protests need to be disbanded. I don't care how anybody feels about it, this is what I believe. You're literally putting signs against guns. You're having a sign versus a gunfight right now. And it's not going in and tearing down a statue is not gonna help you get any rights. You need to arm yourself and protect yourself from possible invasion from outsiders. And that's what I respect about the 3%ers doing that. But what's going on now in Louisiana is they're getting calls, Chosen Few is getting calls, different clubs are getting called, and certain, they're with people that are fully armed, AKs, the craziest type of military machinery. So now they're standing opposed to the 3%ers and the racists. So what's happening? Racial divide. Now it's the blacks on this side, the whites on this side. And this is exactly what's gonna get us put in a situation where they're gonna bring a UN army on us. I don't see anybody else really saying it. A few other people have said it, and they have gotten banned for speaking the truth. Free speech is on full attack right now. I don't know why. And then certain people, they allow them to voice the same opinions, but they don't get banned. But for some reason, me, I'm getting shadow banned. I don't understand it. Maybe I need to go live so they don't know what I'm talking about and they can't censor it. But they're suppressing. I mean, and I could show you factually where I'm being suppressed. Like certain videos, they're not showing like they're showing everything else. And I see that the view duration is very high. People are watching it through. The click-through rate is high, higher than videos that I got 50,000, 60,000, 70,000, 80 views on. So it's like, why is it that these videos statistically have more people watching them for a longer period of time, but they're not getting the reach as the other videos when I'm speaking the truth? But negativity, that they'll give that millions and millions of views. But if I'm telling you not to get caught up in black and white bullshit, because let's just call it what it is already. There's blacks on both sides. There's whites on both sides. There's black 3%ers, Spanish 3%ers. There's white BLM. It's all bullshit. And it's all, if you really do your history and look at it, it's floating all over the internet. And listen, I'm going to go uncut and I'm going to really go all in. And they're probably going to give me shit for this. And I don't care anymore. Because this country, I love this country, and I'm not going to let it go to shit. If anything I could say that could sway somebody to understand that we need to put black and white to the side, because it doesn't make sense. It really doesn't make sense. Why do you hate somebody just because of their color? It does not make sense. And there's people, there's wealthy people that are black. There's wealthy people that are white that don't give a shit about you. There's colors on both sides of this fight. So why are you making it a black and white thing? We need to protect our country right now. Our country is, I feel that our country is not America anymore. I feel like we've already been conditioned to believe that it's still America, but in reality, it's the United Nations. I believe that our country has been sold out. I believe that they're using the media instead of just coming and bringing army and just shooting everybody down like they used to do back in the days. They have mind control with the media. They could just make you believe that everything is the same, but it's not. Why? This isn't China. China suppresses the internet. China doesn't allow you. You know, it's a communist place that doesn't allow you to have freedom of speech. Since when in America do we not have freedom of speech? Since when is it okay for them to shadow ban us? Why is it that we can't speak the truth? What is going on that this day and age, if you post something about, you know, fires and riots and all that, it goes viral. But if you say we need to stop, you get shadow banned. Really look deep into it. Why would they shadow ban positivity? It's because we've been infiltrated. Our country is under attack right now. We are literally living in a day and age where if you wear a hat that says make America great again, listen to the words, make America great again, that is considered racist. What kind of America do you live in where making it great is racist? And listen, everybody is on this, I hate Trump, I like Trump. Listen, I don't care about any of that. I'm just saying, look at what he represents. Look at what's being said. Make America great again. How is that a bad thing? How is that racist? How is the American flag racist? How is it? I don't get it. If you really know history, there were a lot of black people that fought in these wars to end all this. Everybody was not a slave. And what they don't want you to know, if you really think about slavery, all these black people that think, you know, that hate white people and say, oh, they just want us to be slaves again. Do you know that the average white person back in those days does not own slaves? It was the 1% that owned it. It was the elite. It wasn't cheap. You couldn't just go buy a black person. It was people that owned plantation. It was the elite. They're the only ones that cared about having slaves. It wasn't as common as people think. Now, segregation and racism, that's a real thing. Those are issues that can be fixed. But standing, blocking traffic, protesting, I don't see where it's helping anything. All it's doing is making tension high and is making you a target. I see things where people putting their phone in people's face that have a gun pointed at them. You're going to war with a phone and a protest sign against guns. It's time to wake up. You people are really like out of it. Like, I don't know how badly programmed you are, but you need to listen to some affirmations and start loving yourself again. Because this like all this stuff that's going on, you are truly hating yourself and your own people. We need to stick together and come together. These racist groups, listen, my 3%ers that are truly righteous, If you're out there to protect the neighborhood from it getting burned down, you need to tell your brother-in-law, your brother, your friend, whoever it is that happens to be KKK or Confederate or whatever the hell he is. I don't care what group it is. That is not the place for it. They're inciting riots. They are the root of the riots when they do that. And all it takes is one rock to be thrown, and this country is going to get turned upside down. It's happening in so many places right now. And now my worst fear, 1% is getting caught on either side of it. Because you got the chosen few on this side protecting people, and they're not politically involved with BLM. It's not that type of deal. They're just protecting people that they know and love. But I know people in other places that are protecting people they know and love on the other side. So this is what happens. Now you got people armed on both sides. So now you have 1% versus 1%. You have 3% on this side, BLM on this side. It's going to turn into nasty civil war, nasty gunfights. And to be honest, they're going to bring the UN in and sweep everything up if we don't wake up. I need you guys to spread this message. Please share this. They are suppressing it. Give it likes. Give it life. We need to resurrect our country, and we need to get pride back in the flag. We are all Americans. If you don't like being American, why are you here again? There's flights. You people wear expensive clothes, all this money. Take a flight to wherever you think is better. Because people always got something bad to say about America. But where are you going that is better? Wake up. This is it. This is the last chance at freedom. This country is the last chance at freedom. Support the Ghosting Gear. Support the Demons Row Gear. We stand for unity for everybody sitting on them tools, doing what they do. Thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV. This is the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, comment, share this. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.